Hello my dear children and parents, welcome to Indus Valley Public School Raj e-learning classes, class 9th, where we were doing lesson 7 from your Beehive book and the name of the lesson is Packing, written by Jerome K. Jerome. This lesson was related to packing of the three friends who was boasting about their packing skill, but none of them proved to be a good packer. There was chaos and confusion. And finally, what happened, we have already seen in the chapter, packing was a mess. Okay, so we have already completed with the lesson. Now in this video, I will be giving you the summary, question answers, theme of the lesson. So move ahead. First, it's introduction of the lesson. Packing is an extract from Jerome K. Jerome's novel, Three Men in a Boat. This is humorous extract about the confusion and mess created by people who are inexperienced in the art of packing. It exposes the utter clumsiness of the three friends, Jerome, George, and Harris. They consider themselves to be skilled in the art of packing, but in reality, all of them have little knowledge about working in an organized manner. Now, theme and message of the lesson. Theme. Packing is based on the theme that routine tasks are not as easy as they seem to be. The humorous account amuses the reader with the chaotic and confusing situations created by the clumsiness of three friends, all of whom considered packing to be child's play. The chapter humorously describe the do's and don'ts of packing. Packing should be treated as frivolous, that means playful activity, but as a serious task that involves concentration and deftness. Another message the account gives is that if we have a pet, it should be well trained. Now, summary of the lesson. Jerome, Harris, and George are three friends who are about to set out on a journey. The story begins with the important task of packing stuff for this journey. Jerome, the narrator, overestimates his packing skills and tells his friends to let him handle it all by himself. However, his real intention is to make Jerome and Harris do the packing under his supervision and guidance. But his friends take his advice seriously and, to his great shock, stress themselves comfortably, leaving him with all the running around. Though irritated with their attitude, Jerome straight away gets busy with packing. After a long drawn packing session, he finally straps up the bag. Both his friends watching him quietly. And when he is done with packing, Harris declares that the shoes have been left unpacked. The bag has to be reopened again to accommodate the shoes. An irritated Jerome is just done with packing the shoe when he is reminded of his toothbrush. Unsure about having packed his toothbrush, Jerome has to empty the bag and hunt through all its contents to locate the brush. After a lot of efforts, he finds the brush in one of the boots. Anyhow, the bag is packed again. The next query comes from George regarding the soap. Jerome is so irritated by this time that he does not even bother about his query and straps up the bag. But the very next moment, he has to unpack it again as he had packed his spectacles by mistake. Eventually, it is past 10 when packing is finally done. Keeping in mind the amount of time taken by Jerome to pack the bag, George and Harris decided to pack the hampers themselves and show Jerome the real art of packing. However, they are equally clumsy and break a cup at the very outset. This is followed by squashing a tomato treading on the butter and smashing the pie by putting heavy things on them. Salt flies all over while they are packing. After peeling the butter off Jaws slipper, they try unsuccessfully to squeeze it into the kettle. They finally scrape it and put it down on the chair. Harris sits on it and the butter gets stuck to his back. Then both these men go about searching for the butter all over the room. Later, George locates it behind Harry's back and it is packed in the teapot. Montmorency, their pet dog, contributes his bit to this exercise of picking by sitting on things, climbing into the jam and crushing lemons as thought they were rat. Finally, the packing is done by 12:50 at night. This is followed by a discussion on the wake-up time and George is so tired that he sleeps off even before the time is decided upon. Sirom and Harris decided that 6:30 in the morning would be the right time to get up and then they too go off to sleep. So here we end with the summary. Now coming towards the question answers. Question number one. How many characters are there in the narrative? Name them. Don't forget the dog. There are four characters in the story. They are the narrator Jerome, his friends George and Harris, and a dog named Montmorency. Question number two. Why did the narrator volunteer to do the packing? Jerome was proud of his packing skill, so he offered to do the packing. Actually, he did not intend to do the packing work, but he wanted to supervise his friends and direct them to pack the things right away. How did George and Harris react to this? Did Jerome like their reaction? George and Harris readily agreed to Jerome's plan. They sat on the sofa and the chair respectively and watched Jerome do the packing. Jerome did not like the reaction. Question number four. What was Jerome's real intention when he offered to pack? Jerome did not intend to do packing work, but he wanted to supervise his friends and direct them to pack the right way. Question number five. What did Harris say after the bag was shut and strapped? Why do you think he waited till then to ask? After the bag was shut and strapped, Harris pointed out that Jerome had forgotten to pack his boots. I think that he waited till then because he thought that Jerome would pack the boots in the end. What horrible idea occurred to Jerome a little later? The horrible idea that struck Jerome was that whether he had packed his toothbrush or not. Next question, number seven. Where did Jerome finally find the toothbrush? Jerome found the toothbrush inside a boot. Why did Jerome have to reopen the packed bag? Jerome had to reopen the bag because he had packed his spectacles in it. What does George and Harris offer to pack and why? George and Harris offered to pack the food basket. They did so because they wanted to show that they were better packers than Jerome. What does Jerome say when Montmorency's ambition in life? What do you think of Montmorency and why? Montmorency's aim in life was to create hurdles in the way of others and get scolded for it. I think that Montmorency was a loving pet who liked playing with his masters. Question number 11. Is title packing appropriate? Explain. Children, this is an extra question that I am giving from my side. Go through it. Packing is an appropriate title for this extract from the novel Three Men in a Boat. The three men are Jerome, George and Harris. They have to go on a pleasure boat journey and have to pack for it. All three of them think they are past masters in the art of packing, but all they end up creating is an utter mess. They are disorganized, unplanned, foolish, careless and unsystematic and cannot properly pack a thing. They blame each other for being poor at packing, and each boasts of his packing acumen. Acumen means their skill, their intelligence. Thus, this tract is all about packing, and therefore the title is appropriate. So children, here we end with the lesson. Last is, that is summary, question answers. So revise the lesson. Feel free if any doubt is there. And thank you for watching the video. Go through it, write summary, question answers, and send me your copy for correction. Thank you so much.